probably.
Good morning. Please stay standing for our national anthem. And now for our Vermont state song.
These green hills and silver waters are my home. They belong to me, and to all of her sons and daughters, they may be strong and forever free. Let us live to protect her beauty and look with pride on her golden dome. They say home is where the heart is. These green mountains are my home. are my home.
Great job. Great job. Okay.
Do you want me to go?
Good morning, guests. My name is Noel Green, and I have the honor of serving as principal of Burlington High School. Thank you for joining us on this momentous occasion as we celebrate the graduating class of 2019. Thank you to our band and our singers for those wonderful performances. I will now turn the, go ahead. You can give it to them again. I will now turn the program over to our MC, Lauren Gibson.
Good morning, honored guests, friends, family members, faculty, staff, and students. My name is Lauren Gibson, and on behalf of the class of 2019, I am pleased and proud to welcome you to the 2019 commencement exercises. It is with great pleasure I introduce our first speaker this morning, selected by the vote of the senior class, English teacher Mr. Matthew Yu.
All right. Thank you, Lauren. Good morning. First, I'd like to thank the Burlington High School class of 2019 for the honor of being chosen to speak in front of all of you beautiful people today. I was particularly glad that I was able to be the speaker for this class, so thanks again. The honor of being chosen as class speaker carries its weight of expectations. Now, I certainly don't think I'm extraordinarily wise, nor am I near as experienced as some of the master teachers at this historic institution, but I think my 27 years on this earth could be helpful in some contexts. So, here are some words. Soon-to-be graduates, over these past 4 years, we've seen some stuff. But most importantly, we grew up some. We've made and fostered new relationships and gained experiences and tools that, supposedly, are going to help us with our next steps. As usual with the notion of the future, there are fears and anxieties. But considering what I know about the intellect, leadership, and the character of this class, I think we're ready to face the future head on. Check out this nifty toolbox you're leaving with. You can speak up when you see injustices, even when it is easier to be a bystander. You are creative problem solvers. You can express yourselves in a variety of ways. You understand the value of holding yourselves accountable for leaving the world a better place than you found it. You see, I think what's key to using these tools is remembering that the tools aren't just empty phrases, your grades, proficiencies, or the piece of paper you're going to get after I'm done talking. The tools are what you've taken from your experiences up to this point. Lessons you've learned from taking lefts instead of rights, from forgetting intent versus impact, and from one of the greatest teachers in life, pain. Pain can be versatile. It's not just a demonic toe-stubbing incident. It can come in forms of rejection, disappointment, loss, failure. I wish younger me had been introduced to pain and failure as the important teachers that they are. Their roles were eventually made clear to me when I was changing majors in college, twice. I thought I knew what I wanted to be when I grew up. But when I got to college, my feelings changed. Architecture was more intense than I thought it'd be. I thought engineering was close enough, so I switched over, but realized I don't vibe with math and that particular type of problem solving. It became clear that I had to look for another path. My mom highly disagreed with my choices, and being the rock of my life, that really impacted me. I felt like I was lost. Failing my mom, my dreams, past teachers, friends, myself, everything. It was terrifying. My future, which I had always thought I had a clear picture of, was disintegrating into a cloud of mystery and uncertainty. But this ended up being the best thing for me. I had a passion for literature, took a leap, and majored in something I do vibe with, and it led me to giving you this speech today.
True, true.
There is truth in that some of the toughest moments of life are what end up defining a person. And this was certainly true for me. Question is, how will you handle adversity in your lives? Well, how did I handle it myself? Instead of asking, why me? I've gotten pretty good at asking, what can I learn from this? I can guarantee that the latter will be more helpful to you. It's not always the easy route. I found that out too. But it's the route of growth. It's the route of truth. It's the route of further understanding who you are. And when you have a clearer understanding of who you are, your world feels more complete. Things do get better when you are determined to learn from life's challenges. American philosopher and Burlington native John Dewey theorized about a particular bond that we all share. That the deepest urge in human nature is the desire to be important. Now that's a thinker. Nothing about money or happiness, fame, a long life, how many likes you get on Instagram, or having a family. We all have the desire to feel important. So perhaps instead of worrying so much about how you're going to get that six-figure salary or how many likes you're going to get on social media posts, have you ever tried asking yourself, what makes me feel truly important? And if you're doing what makes you feel important, isn't that enough? Think back to those lessons you've learned from pain and failure. It is these lessons which will help you gain clearer insight on what's important. I firmly believe, heck, maybe I might even say I know, that once you feel like you're doing what you're supposed to be doing, once the results of your struggle for excellence through failure after failure makes you feel fulfilled, you will know you have realized and accepted your importance in the world. I know I've told you a lot up to this point. So, I'll end with some words to recenter ourselves as we leave this building. I thought it'd be appropriate to end with a poem about failure. So for one last time, this one's called You Failed, But It'll Be Okay by me. You may close your eyes, you can put your head down, as long as you're taking this one in. Quietly, thank you very much. There in my class. You Failed, But It'll Be Okay by Matthew Yu. You failed, but it'll be okay. You applied to that school, but you didn't get in. You asked out that guy. He said, no way. You prepared that presentation, but nobody listened. You applied to that school, but now you know how to better present yourself for your next application. You asked out that guy, but now you know whom you really need in life. You did that presentation. You did a presentation. That's another one under the belt, and public speaking skills are a hot commodity. You failed in the past. You will continue to fail. You fail because you're human. You failed, but it'll be okay as long as you learn from it. Thank you. Appreciate it. Don't be defined by your failures. But like the poet said, learn from them. It is important. You are important. Congratulations, class of 2019. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Mr. Yu. I am now pleased to introduce our first student speaker, Zenavia Wilcox, selected by the vote of the class of 2019.
Thank you, Lauren. Hello, my name is Zenavia Wilcox, and it is my pleasure to welcome students, families, and faculty to this day of celebration here at Burlington High School. Today, we're celebrating the end of one of the major milestones of our lives and the beginning of the larger journey of life. Freshman year, most of us entered those AE lobby doors, not understanding why there was a line of teachers screaming and clapping as we started our high school experience. Every year moving forward, I remember being so excited to see how differently people looked or acted after summers apart from one another. Now, looking at a photo of myself. Now, looking at a photo of myself from freshman year, a photo that I regret, and I'm sure many of you, looking back at yours, regret as well, I realize just how much happier I've become, how much more determined I am, and how passionate I've grown. So how did I get this happy, you may ask? Well, junior year, it really hit me. I realized I had cared so much about the growth and change of my peers that I neglected to grow and define myself. As a result of cultural and educational experiences during that year, I finally became open to growth. For example, I surrounded myself with family. My siblings have always been there for me, but in my own ignorance, I didn't realize that until I was in my most stressful of times. They were the ones to hold my hand and support me through it all. I also found mentors and teachers who opened my mind to new ways of thinking. I discovered opportunities for growth at BHS and took advantage of them. Through all this, I came to realize exactly how lucky I am. I realize I am so privileged to have teachers whom I call my role models. A family who loves me unconditionally, and a supportive community like Burlington High School. However, the greatest realization of all was that I was loved. Maya Angelou once said, "Love recognizes no barriers. It jumps hurdles, leaps fences, penetrates walls to arrive at its destination full of hope." I'm standing here as a result of all the love and support I was not only given, but realized I had. I stand here full of hope and ready for whatever the future may bring. Today, you're sitting in these chairs because someone loves you. At some point, someone believed in you and who you could become. Someone took the time to let you know you could amount to so much more. But now it's time to believe in yourself. But first, I'd like to give you all your last high school assignment. Let someone know you're thankful. And I don't mean the thank you you give when someone holds the door open in the hallway, or when someone hands you something you drop on the classroom floor. A genuine thank you. So before I leave, I'd like to express some of my own gratitude. I'd like to thank all you amazing teachers for challenging us in so many ways and always pushing us to strive for more. I'd like to thank all the women in my family because you've shown me, through example, the true ways of a powerful Black woman. And lastly, I'd like to thank my peers, classmates, friends, from the bottom of my heart. You have contributed to the realization of the person I am today and the one I hope to be in the future. So for that, I truly thank you. Honestly, it's a brave new world out there. And if anyone can make the best of it and learn from it, I'm sure we can. To my fellow graduates, we've made it. Congratulations to the class of 2019. I hope you all discover your own realizations and remember to be thankful. Thank you.
Thank you, Zenavia. Our second student speaker, also voted by the senior class, is Isaac Gentleman.
Thank you, Lauren. Hello, everyone. I want to start today by talking about community service, something with which I hope all of us have had at least 40 hours of experience with. Parents and guardians, if you've never heard of BHS's service requirement, or if you see your child nervously shifting around in their seat right now, you might be in for an awkward diploma-less conversation after today's ceremony. All jokes aside, I wanted to begin by talking about service because for 4 years, as part of my 40 hours, I volunteered at the BHS graduation. Freshman year, I was an involuntary volunteer. My mother made a strong suggestion that I fulfill some of my service requirement and help out. I begrudgingly gave up my second day of summer vacation and signed up. After handing out programs and ushering people to their seats, the ceremony began and I was able to watch. In the teacher section too, so I got the best seats. I watched wide-eyed as speakers spoke and awards were presented. Then it came time for the presentation of diplomas. I watched as each diploma was given, each tassel was flipped, and that was it. I didn't understand. I felt like I had been cheated. I thought to myself, 3 years of work ahead and all I'd get in return is a piece of paper and a polyester cord flipped from the right side of my head to the left. Perhaps it was the bitterness at the summer day I was missing, but the whole thing seemed inconsequential. Then something funny happened. Each subsequent year, I voluntarily volunteered and was able to attend the graduation ceremony. And each year, as I got closer to my own graduation, I began to notice that those insignificant practices became increasingly more significant. Now it's our own senior year, and I think it finally makes sense. Because while the practices themselves may seem trivial, the weight of what's behind them is anything but that. This diploma we're about to receive represents our entire education up until this point. Look closely, and you'll see each year of high school, every project, presentation, and portfolio layered on that one sheet of 8.5 by 11. Look even closer and you'll begin to see what really matters. Because while our knowledge of the Gadsden Purchase or that the mitochondria is the powerhouse of the cell may fade or be forgotten over time, what will endure and remain invaluable is the true learning we have all done over the past 4 years. How to be ourselves. We have each grown considerably since our first day of freshman year. We have become adults, compassionate, unique, and determined. This is the true heart of our education. So today, when you walk up on stage and receive your diploma, don't think of it as just a piece of paper, even though it is. Instead, think of it as a foundation upon which all of the rest of your life will be built. The rest of your life. This is where the tassel comes in. If the diploma is your work and process of what's come before, then the tassel is what comes next. At this point in the speech, a lot of graduation speakers try to impart some learned wisdom or forecast the future. So what comes next, you ask? I have absolutely no clue. We take so much time talking about the beginnings and the ends, but rarely do we talk about the transitions of life. This is the only thing assured for us when we leave today, a period of transition. It's a lot less exciting than a graduation, and a lot more uncomfortable. Perhaps this is why it's often glossed over in the more aspirational speeches. However, I think these transitions are foolish to forget, because we as humans grow the most not at the start or ends of our journeys, but in the moments of movement, where we have zero idea of what comes next. The tassel represents this moment of insecurity. It's uncomfortable in its awkwardness, getting caught in our mouths and up our noses, and you're never sure where it will land. But it's also full of motion as it moves from one side of our head to the other, marking the transition from one chapter of our lives to the next. When you inevitably encounter this transition, follow the tassel's example. Don't conform to one particular shape. Be flexible, and most of all, be unafraid to get a little tangled along the way. While prepping for this speech, I read and watched other speeches for inspiration, and I think it was after my fourth world's best graduation speech that I realized, wow, every high school in the country has the kids that are going to solve climate change and end poverty. And while that's definitely not out of the realm of possibility for our graduating class, I have a slightly different message to instill. Be yourself. Of course, go out into the world and do great things, but first breathe and find your own individuality. These objects represent a great achievement in our lives. But at the end of the day, the diploma is just a piece of paper, and the tassel is only a polyester cord flipped from the right side of our head to the left. It is up to us to find their meaning. Congratulations, class of 2019. Thank you.
Thank you, Isaac. Mr. Noel Green, Burlington High School principal, will now present the graduation awards.
Let's give our speakers another round of applause, please. I am pleased to present honors and awards this morning. Please hold your applause until after each recognition. Burlington teachers, staff, administrators, and school board members, please stand. Thank you for your dedication, compassion, and high expectations for the class of 2019. Please be seated. The first awards that we're going to celebrate, or students that we're going to celebrate, are our summa cum laude scholars. When you hear your name, please stand and face the audience. Ian Barnaby. Alexandra Contreras Montesano. Stephen Doe. Emmanuel Dodson, Jackson Elder, Kent Ford, Anna Halliday, Zoe Kenninger, Curtis Plant. These are our summa cum laude scholars. These students earned this award by having a GPA of 4.1 or higher all 4 years of high school. Yes, I know, that's very impressive. Which is why they're wearing the gold stoles. Thank you. Next is our magna cum laude scholars. Please, again, when you hear your name, stand and face the audience. Leona Bauman, Maureen Bauman, Isabel Block, Nicholas Bovair, Milo Borishis, Seamus Brennan, Alaya Burr, Ada Case, Colin Dean, Thomas Didi, Janizair Diaz Cartagena, Ava Edwards Stoll, Kelsey Francis, Veronica Fusser, Ava Ingalls, Isaac Gentleman, Galen Kilburn, Simon Kassam, Sarah Lee, Gian Martinez Hernandez, Claire Maxwell, Elizabeth McConnell, David Melkomov, Fatumo Mohammed, Elliot Montrell, Hallie Newman, Joshua Scheidt, Lillian Shaw, Seamus Stein. These are your magna cum laude scholars. These students, wearing the silver stoles, earned a GPA of 3.8 or higher for all 4 years of high school. Magna cum laude scholars, please be seated. Next, we celebrate our cum laude scholars. So again, when you hear your name, please stand and face the audience. Tasneem Adulemi, Mason Beck, Nicholas Benelli, Gabriella Burra, Finnezy Brown, Isabella Bucci, Emma Downey, Caitlin Ducharme, Jonathan Fabian, Senga Felikenny, Olivia Genchos, Bebek Gurung, Magdalena Hanley, Kaylee Hayes, McCall Heimert, Sydney Holt Barker, Anna Jeffers, Tenzin Kelly, Malachi LaForce, Justin Lai, Megan Lavoy, Cho Nguyen, Duncan McDonald, Jesse McDonald, Avina Mansky, Vaughn Martin, Emma McCobb, Madison Messier, Luke Michael, Donovan Montgomery, Samuel Mutar, Denise Neal, Natalie Noble, Saran Osaini, Simran Paget, Anna Zoe Peterson, Prabin Pradhan, Gina Rai, Giselle Rainville, Sophia St. John Lockridge, Bindi Sirawal, Hussein Tamang, Carly Treat, Aiden Trombley, Emma True, Madeline Tribus, Fat Vo, Alden Wheeler. These are our cum laude scholars. These students, recognized by their maroon stoles, earned a GPA of 3.5 or higher for all 4 years of high school. Thank you, cum laude scholars. You may be seated. At this time, National Honor Society members, please stand and turn to be recognized. The students wearing the blue and white cords are life members of the Green Mountain Chapter of the National Honor Society. National Honor Society members, thank you. Please be seated. Jackson Elder, please stand and face the audience. The U.S. Presidential Scholar's Honor is a national honor. Jackson was one of 161 nationwide students selected. There are two students selected from each state and other specially selected students in the arts and career technical education. It is a great honor that U.S. Secretary of Education announced the selection of Jackson as one of the few American high school seniors who have demonstrated outstanding academic achievement, artistic excellence, leadership, citizenship, service, and contribution to school and community. The U.S. Presidential Scholar will be honored for their accomplishments in Washington, D.C. from June 24th through June 26th. Congratulations, Jackson Elder. Will the following students rise and face the audience when you hear your name? Curtis Plant, Zoe Kenninger, Alexandra Contreras Montesano, please stand. The Howard Educational Award is given to the students with the three highest academic averages all 4 years. Curtis Plant, Zoe Kenninger, and Alexandra Contreras Montesano. Please be seated. Please stand, Alexandra Contreras Montesano, and face the audience. The Alumni Association Award is given for excellence in English, Alexandra Contreras Montesano. Please stand, Alexandra Contreras Montesano. The Mary E. Pease History Award for having earned the highest average for 4 years in history is given by the class of 1924. Please congratulate Alexandra Contreras Montesano. Please stand, Anna Halliday, and face the audience. The Alumni Association Award is given for outstanding work in science. Anna Halliday, congratulations. Please stand, Alexandra Contreras Montesano. The Alumni Association Award is given for outstanding work in design technology education. Alexandra Contreras Montesano, congratulations. Please stand, Anna Halliday. The Tony Tromo Award for Excellence in Mathematics is presented to the graduating senior who has excelled in and out of the classroom in the field of mathematics and who shows great promise in math or math-related field of study. Congratulations, Anna. Please stand, Zoe Kenninger. The alumni, I heard a couple of claps. Wait 1 second. The Alumni Association Award is given for outstanding work in world languages. Zoe Kenninger, congratulations. Please stand, Maureen Bauman. The Ruth Henderson Memorial Award is given by the class of 1948 to the student demonstrating outstanding business skills. Congratulations, Maureen. Please stand, Caitlin Blaze. The Alumni Association Award is given for consistent performance in art. Congratulations, Caitlin. Please stand. Aiden Trombley. The James H. Cook, Adrian E. Holmes Award is given for outstanding achievement and dedication to music at BHS for all 4 years. Congratulations, Aiden. I would now like to call forward Mr. Carl Lisman. The William B. Hackett Award in Athletics will be presented by Carl Lisman for the class of 1963.
Donovan Montgomery, stand up. Bill Hackett would have been a member of the class of 1963 if on a warm, sunny day in June of 1961, almost exactly 58 years ago, he had not given up his life in a heroic attempt to save the life of a friend. Class of 1963 presents the William B. Hackett Sportsmanship Award in his memory to a member of the senior class at BHS. At the time of his death, we had just completed our sophomore year. Bill was an outstanding athlete and an active participant in school activities, and a warm, friendly, and modest fellow. It's not often that a person can be described as liked by everyone, but Bill was just that. He was admired by his classmates, competitors, teachers, and parents. The senior boy who receives this award has been judged to exemplify as nearly as possible the qualities inherent in the character of Bill Hackett, including good sportsmanship and courage. Bill was respected for his loyalty, sincerity, fairness, and honesty on the running track and especially the football field. His team spirit and incredible athletic prowess inspired all with whom he was associated. Donovan Montgomery is the winner this year of the William B. Hackett Sportsmanship Award.
Thank you, Mr. Lisman. Please stand. Claire Maxwell and Henry Wool. The Seahorse Pride Award is given to a senior male and senior female athlete whose character, dedication, and especially sportsmanship exemplify the spirit and high ideals of Burlington High School athletics. Congratulations, Claire and Henry. Please stand, Nathan Allard. The F.V. Moore Memorial Award is given by the class of 1922 to students who have made outstanding academic progress during the past 4 years by vote of the faculty. Congratulations, Nathan Allard. Will the following students please stand and face the audience? Emmanuel Dotson, Hallie Newman, Seamus Stein, Zenavia Wilcox. Alumni Association Service Awards are given to the class of 1925 to the students who have shown outstanding service to their class and to their school by vote of the faculty. Congratulations to Manny, Hallie, Seamus, and Zenavia. Thank you. Please stand, Anna Zoe Peterson. The Mary E. P. Citizenship Award is given by the class of 1948 to the student who shows quality of good citizenship by vote of the faculty. Congratulations, Anna Zoe Peterson. Please stand, Elizabeth McConnell. The Florence E. Green Teaching Award is given to a student who plans to enter the teaching profession by vote of the faculty. Congratulations to Elizabeth McConnell. Thank you. Will the following students please stand up? Emmanuel Dodson. Anna Halliday, Simon Kassam, Elliot Montrell. These are National Merit Scholarship finalists, chosen over 16,000 students in the United States for the potential success in rigorous college studies. Please give them a hand. Emmanuel Dodson, Anna Halliday, Simon Kassam, Elliot Montrell, for being National Merit Scholar finalists. Will the following students please stand to be recognized? Michaela Centerbar, Thomas Nguyen, Sarah Lee, Carly Treat. The Barbara Gauntlet Scholars Program, upon application and selection by the Barbara Gauntlet Committee, recognizes students from Burlington High School who have earned academic averages of B minus or better. These Barbara Gauntlet Scholars are eligible for one-year scholarships to assist them with their post-secondary education. Congratulations, Michaela, Thomas, Sarah, and Carly. Thank you. I am now going to turn the program back over to our MC, Lauren Gibson.
Thank you, Mr. Green. Now, for the moment we've all been waiting for. Mr. Yao Bang, Superintendent of the Burlington Schools, and Ms. Claire Wool, Burlington Board of School Commissioners, Mr. Herbert Perez, Assistant Principal, and Mayor Moreau Weinberger will now present the diplomas to the class of 2019.
You got it. Where's their card? Okay, I need their cards. Abdullah Abdulaziz. Abdulrazak Abdulrazak. Tasneem Adalemi. Nathan Allard. Alexander Anicic. Christian Asaro Perriman. Haley Baldwin.
Victoria Baldwin. Marie Banza. Ian Barnaby. Leona Bauman. Marin Bauman. Milano Bauer. Mason Beck. Nicholas Benelli. Caitlin Blaze. Isabel Block. Gabriella Boera. Nicholas Bovair. Milo Borishus. Aaron Breen. Seamus Brennan. Finnezy Brown. Sky Brown. Isabella Bucci. Theo Bucher. Aliyah Burr. Ada Case. Hannah Kate. Michaela Centerbar. Sean Clark. Sarah Clemens Sparks. Alexandra Contreras Montesano. Margaret Corville. Emily Crowley. Hannah Crowley. Jacinda Cup. Trace Cushing. Erica Custodia. Colin Dean. Thomas Didi. Daniel Delante. Aiden Devitt. Genizar Diaz Cartagena. Naron Job. Stephen Doe. Emmanuel Dotson. Emma Downey. Caitlin Ducharme. Sylvie Dvorak. Eva Edwards Stahl. Jackson Elder. Madeline Evans. Jonathan Fabian. Claudine Felicchini. Mawa Felicchini. Senga Felicchini. Desiree Fisher. Kent Ford. Kelsey Francis. Veronica Fusar. Tessa Gardner. Olivia Genchos. Crystal Goodwin. Lauren Gibson. Sylvia Greeno. Asis Gurung. Bibek Gurung. Rajesh Gurung. Damir Hirovich. Anna Halliday. William Halpern. James Hammond. Magdalena Hanley. Faisa Hassan. Nurto Hassan. Ahmed Hassan. Kaylee Hayes. Cage Hailed Failing. McCall Heimert. Nora Higgins. Kaya Hill. Ellis Hodgson. Sydney Holt Barker. Ali Hussein. Thomas Nguyen. Tony Nguyen. Fatuma Ibrahim. Jamilo Iftin. Ava Ingalls. Silas Jackson. Hamdi Jafar. Anna Jeffers. Isaac Gentleman. Tila Cadell. Ophelia Keith. Tenzin Kelly. Charlotte Camney. Galen Kilburn. Tanner King. Simon Kasam. Zoe Kenninger. Chris Combo. Emily Lequier. Shannon LaBelle. Malachi LaForce. Justin Lai. Kristen Landry. Michael Langlais. Megan Lavoy. Sarah Lee. Habiba Liban. Ismahan Liban. Jared Libby. Joe Lewin. Duncan McDonald. Jesse McDonald. Jesse McCumber. Ajay Magar. Premika Magar. Elliot Mayer. Avina Mansky. Vaughn Martin. Gian Martinez Hernandez. Claire Maxwell. Tao McCann. Emma McCobb. Elizabeth McConnell. Riley McGrath. Skylar McKenzie. Josiah McSweeney. Irvin Madar. David Milkomov. Madison Messier. Luke Michael. Caitlin Miles. Nima Modest. Abdirahman Mohammed. Fatuma Mohammed. Elijah Molina. Donovan Montgomery. Elliot Montrell. Hussein Mubarak.
Congratulations.
Samuel Mutar. Denise Neal. Sarah Namaya. Hallie Newman. David Nguyen. Elena Nguyen. Medine Nafasha. Natalie Noble. Emerson Osmond. Saran Osini. Simran Paget. Glenna Parker. Nicholas Parrott. Malik Pearson Fitzpatrick. Kelsey Peters. Anna Zoe Peterson. Curtis Plunt. Mu Po. Abhishek Pradhan. Jiwan Pradhan. Praveen Pradhan. Gina Rai. Giselle Rainville. Haley Reen. Killian Richmond. Devin Rogers. Wyatt Rollins. Caleb Russo. Devin Rye.
Thank you.
Halima Saeed. Joshua Scheidt. Lily Schwartz.
You're okay.
Baxter Scully. Lillian Shaw. Zoe Sheeran. Bindi Sirawal. Carolyn Smith. Madison Smith. Noah Smith. Savan Suvana. Kelsey Spencer. Noah Spath. Sophia St. John Lockridge. Liam Stanton.
Thank you.
Seamus Stein. William V.R. Stevens. Gitanjali Suba. Nima Sugo. Hussein Tamang. Ful Tamang. Roman Tapa. Brandon Lee Thorpe. Ethan Treadwell. Carly Treat. Aiden Trombley. Emma True. Madeline Tribus. Marsden Van Order. Fat Vo. T. Le Wa. Alden Wheeler. Zanavia Wilcox. Henry Wool.
Burlington High School seniors, you are now Burlington High School graduates. Please stand up. I gotta wait for Manny. I gotta wait for you. Please turn your tassels from right to left. There we go. Congratulations, class of 2019. Wait, sit back down, please. We're not ready to go yet. They're so anxious to graduate, they're ready to go. But we got a couple more things. Thank you, graduates. We have some final remarks from our wonderful MC who did such a great job today, Lauren Gibson.
Thank you, Mr. Green. I would like to take this opportunity to ask my classmates to thank everyone who shared this celebration with us by giving them a round of applause. Class of 2019, we have now walked this stage, received our diplomas, and officially graduated from Burlington High School. So I think it's time for one last piece of advice. As soon as you walk out of this gym, the rest of your life will begin. Many of us will be attending colleges this fall, taking a gap year, beginning a new job, joining the military, and setting out on countless adventures. We will be on our own. We will make good and bad decisions. Life will be hard sometimes, but we must never give up. Because if we remember not to give up, then we will find our way through whatever challenges may come. The idea of these challenges may seem frightening today, but by not giving up, you will become the best that you can be. This becoming starts now, and it is the perfect opportunity for us to start learning how to be independent. As this ceremony comes to an end, I want to wish you all the very best of luck, happiness, and success. So good luck on your journeys, don't give up, and may we never forget the time we spent together at BHS. Thank you, class of 2019.